Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic in the subject, embedded system was overview of AMBA. So AMBA is nothing but advanced microcontroller bus architecture. A for advanced, M for microcontroller, B for bus, and A for architecture. So with the help of this abbreviation, we came to know over that we are discussing about the bus architecture. So we already know the bus architecture consisting of the control bus, address bus, and data bus. So whatever the communication that we need to a communication between the processors or the controllers to the external devices or the internal devices, everything will be done by with the help of bus. So far we have seen the bus architectures. Now let's see what is this advanced microcontroller bus architecture. So advanced means obviously some advanced features will be extended to the normal bus architecture. So let's see what is this. The advanced microcontroller bus architecture specifications defines it is an on-chip communication standard for designing high performance embedded microcontroller. So the main thing of designing this AMBA, rather than connecting the external buses or anything, it is an on-chip communication. So in the chip itself, we are having a communication. So that is the main advanced feature of this bus architecture. So an on-chip communication standard for designing high performance embedded microcontrollers. So there are different types of advanced microcontroller bus architectures will be there. So the three distinct buses are defined within the AMBA specification. So what are those three different bus architectures, advanced bus architectures? That is the AHB, advanced high performance bus. A is advanced, HB means high performance bus. Next, advanced system bus. SB means, S means system. Okay, so advanced high bus performance, advanced system bus, and advanced peripheral bus. Okay, it's easy to remember that A is nothing but advanced high performance bus, system bus, and peripheral bus. So these are the three different buses which are defined within the AMBA specifications. Okay, so based on your the operations, actually the advanced microcontroller bus architecture consisting of these three buses will be present. The three distinct buses will be present in this advanced microcontroller bus architecture. So here you can see this is a bus structure. This is advanced microcontroller bus architecture. High bandwidth external memory interface is there. Okay, means just you are connecting some external devices. If you want to connect the external devices, okay, external devices to some of the peripheral devices, everything, all the are connected. So let's take the master one and the master two and the RAM slots, everything is there. So these are the external devices and these are the external devices. So these are all connected with the help of the buses. So far we have seen this bus architecture is a combination of address bus, data bus, and control bus. Then what about this advanced microcontroller bus architecture? This advanced microcontrol bus architecture consisting of three different buses. One is AHB, that is advanced high bus, ASB, advanced system bus, and APB, advanced peripheral bus. So if you want to connect the external peripheral devices, you need to connect those peripheral devices, universal asynchronous receiver transmitter, UART, timer, keypad, PIO, okay, programmable interrupt, input output. So these external peripherals are connected to APB bus, advanced peripheral bus. So that will be connected with the help of the internal bridge. A bridge circuit will be there. So a bridge is going to be send the master devices to this high performance bus. Okay, and here the internal, so this everything is the internal, the controller on chip, this everything is the on chip. circuit. In the on-chip, you are having the high-performance ARM processor will be there. Okay, so this is completely one chip, on-chip. In on-chip, you are having the master, let's take the processor as a master one. High-performance ARM processor, high-bandwidth on-chip RAM will be there, decoder, arbiter, DMA bus master 2. So these are all connected to this, a communication between these devices will be with the help of AHB, advanced high performance bus or advanced system bus. Whatever based on your requirement and the configurations, you can select AHB or ASB. Okay, so bridge in on chip, you are having advanced high performance or advanced system bus. Okay, and the external, if you want to connect the external devices, you can connect to the advanced peripheral bus. And here some high bandwidth external memory interface will be connected. Okay, so whenever the master one is in active state, this master two becomes a slave. Whenever this master two DMA is in active, this processor becomes the slave. So AHB to APB bridge or ASB to APB bridge. Okay, so let's see the main objective of this architecture. What is the main objective of this advanced microcontroller bus architecture? The advanced microcontroller bus architecture specification has been derived to satisfy four key requirements. To satisfy these four key requirements, they are designed this advanced microcontroller bus architecture. Those four key requirements are to facilitate the right first time development. The first thing is, with the help of these AMBA, we are going to facilitate the right first time development. That means right first time development of embedded microcontrollers products with one or more CPUs or signal processors. And the next requirement is to be technology independent, and also it ensures the highly reusable peripherals. It is going to be technology independent and highly reusable peripherals. To encourage modular system design to improve the processor independence by providing a development roadmap for advanced cache. So this modular system design is going to providing a development or roadmap for advanced cache CPU cores, and that as well as the development of peripheral libraries. So this modular system design is going to be used for this development of peripheral libraries and the advanced CPU cache. And to minimize the silicon infrastructure which required to support efficient on-chip and off-chip communication, it is going to be support the efficient on-chip and off-chip communication for both operations and manufacturing test. So these are the main objective for using this AMBA. To facilitate the right first time development, it is a technology independent, as well as ensure the highly reusable peripherals. To encourage modular system design, this modular system design is going to be providing a development on advanced CAS CPU cores, as well as the development of peripheral libraries, and to minimize the silicon infrastructure. Okay, so an AMBA based microcontroller typically consists of a high performance system backbone, that was the AHP and or ASP, advanced high performance bus or advanced system bus, which is able to sustain the external memory bandwidth on which the CPU on chip memory DMA will be resides. Okay, so this is the overview of, that is the architecture of advanced microcontroller bus architecture. So in the next video, we will discuss these the three distinct buses that are present in this AMBA, that is advanced high performance bus and advanced peripheral buses. Thank you.